And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm the RPG chick. Are we running smoothly? We seem to be. Because I haven't moved yet. I don't know who's saying that.
Yeah, I guess it didn't go so well.
Try to catch that. Well, at least you can read it. Okay, so we've been... Yeah, we go this way. Now I don't know what these things are. What happens if I stand on them? I effectively cancel them out. Cool. So I need to go this way. Apparently. We're tracking down our saboteur. It was like a actually third person. Trying to set one of the, or both of the other two up. And, so we have to find whoever that third person is. Very clever, huh? They've gone to great lengths, apparently. Get on it straight away. So wait, what's it? It's telling me the tram station. Now, you know, I was going to turn around, but there's nothing back there. We can get on the... Okay, I was like, there's a wall. We can use the tram station to get to... Yeah, back on the Nexus operations, or to the cryo bay on this very same ship. Kind of strange, though, we're using a... A tram to go to somewhere else on a ship. Are we going off the ship and back on? Or is it a tram that's on the ship and connects to the tram on the Nexus? I have no idea. Because a forward... It wants me to go back on a tram. We need to find... This is not where he just came from. Those are different people standing there. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's where my brother is. Okay, cool. Yeah, definitely going to be checking on him.
I promise.
He'll be right? Okay, thank you. Nigel.
Pathfinder, I'm Nigel McCoy. Just got out of cryo.
Ah, good morning.
Welcome to Andromeda, Nigel.
Thank you.
Good morning.
It's bittersweet, though. My little brother Dash was stationed on the Nexus.
What'd they call me, Dash?
I just learned he died on Eos, trying to start a settlement.
Oh. I'm sorry for your loss.
That's awful. I'm sorry, Nigel.
Yeah. We were gonna start families out here together.
Oh, hug.
I have a pendant our father wore. Dash had its match. Will you reunite them?
Of course.
In his digital journal, he mentioned a spot on Eos where he'd go to think. If you could leave the pendant there.
Wow. So going to all these different worlds. I'm hoping that if I gather a bunch of quests up, we'll have a bunch of things on one world to do. Like I can investigate the murder evidence, leave the pendant, and whatever else I'm gonna do. You know, look for whether it's a good place to colonize and stuff. Fisher.
Feeling a little better.
Looks good.
Like Fisher, glad to see you're doing better.
That was some expedition, hey? Captain said I'm going in the log as the first human to make contact with the Ket. And Kirkland's the first casualty. Wish it could have gone differently.
Things will get better.
I'm sure there are decent aliens here in Andromeda, too. We just have to find them.
Well, I heard you're Pathfinder now. The sooner you figure out where they're hiding, the better.
Will do. Chin up.
Dr. Carlyle, how goes everything? Is that... That's her brother, isn't it? I gave him facial hair like that, yeah.
Ryder, good to see you. Damn shame about your dad, though. I'm sorry we couldn't save him.
How did he die? We know how he died, asphyxiation. He gave her his helmet. You did your best.
I'm sure you did everything you could.
Yeah, but still, we lost a Pathfinder on my watch. Doesn't sit right.
My dad knew the danger. Part of the job.
Now I just need to make sure your brother here pulls through.
Yes, you do. How is he doing?
How's Scott doing?
His condition stable. I see signs of REM activity in the brain, so he's dreaming. Means all the wiring still works.
How did this happen?
It was dumb luck, really. We hit the scourge at the worst possible moment, just as the stasis revival was kicking in. It's a vulnerable moment, coming out of a 600-year nap, then wham! Circuits fried and overloaded the neural pathways. Don't worry, I'm on it. We're not losing another Ryder.
You better not, mister. We'll be losing a doctor. Are you going to be staying on the Hyperion after you save his life?
Are you staying here on the Hyperion?
You know that moment when you realize you're just getting too old?
No.
Right, look who I'm talking to. Trust me, it happens. For me, it was Habitat 7. Watching you guys running around, dodging lightning and the cat, it's a young man's game. Pains me to admit it, but it's passed me by.
And young woman's game. What will you do here? So he's gonna stay, is what he's saying.
What will you do on the Hyperion?
We still have thousands of people taking a nap here, and they need tending to. And this way, I can look out for Scott.
And when they wake up? Because that's the idea. Why did you come to the Helios Cluster?
How did you end up with the Initiative?
And that.
Well, you reach a point in life where you wonder, is that all there is? I'd accomplished everything in the Milky Way I could. I was locked into a future of diminishing returns. So coming here was the world's biggest midlife crisis. A chance to wake up in the morning and feel hope instead of arthritis.
Okay. On that note, I think I'll leave you to saving my brother.
That's all, Harry. Thanks.
Don't be a stranger. If anything changes with Scott, I'll let you know.
Okie dokie. Greer. Hail, Greer. I cannot hail you from the... I cannot hail Greer from the rear.
Greer, how you feeling?
Grateful. If you and Liam hadn't found me in that cave, God knows what those aliens would have done.
We couldn't leave a man behind.
Sure, yeah, we found him on the planet.
Your father. And Kirkland.
They'll be missed.
We'll never forget their sacrifice. It's a brave thing. Risking your life for the greater good.
Yeah. Just seems unfair. We barely got here. I'm sorry I'm not out there with you, but... Kirkland was a friend. And... I'm not cut out for this anymore.
Understood. Habitat 7 was a nasty wake-up call. You take care, Greer.
You too. Thanks again.
Yep, sorry about Kirkland. Let me tell you about this guy named Jenkins. Not Leroy Jenkins. These look like Hot Wheels cars. The kind you get in and vroom vroom. I already looked at the information wall. Well, there's nothing, I'm pretty sure, nothing we have to be doing around here. We have to mess with some security monitors, so I'm not sure where that's done. Watch it there, you're a little freaky. Okay, yeah, nothing down here to look at. I run fast and stuff. Bye! This time the door is open on time, look at that. So it's telling me to go back to the tram. I guess I'm supposed to go back to the Nexus. Oh wait, it's telling me to go here. Oh, docking bay. Oh, I didn't realize I can go to this docking bay. It's so hard to see these little selectables. And it's too bad we can't tab them. You know, hit tab to like highlight them, make them easier to see. Alright, we're going to docking bay. Hey guys, going docking bay! And Cora is joining me.
Ready to see what Tan gave us? I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks and looking great.
Vetra?
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there. In other words, we're making this up as we go.
Oh.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
Wait, are we going on a mission now? I was just going to look around in the docking station. Yeah, we should be able to look around.
They call her the Tempest.
It's kind of psycho look right there. Cool. It's all shiny and stuff. That's a smooth landing.
Let's go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
That's all. Oh. Sorry about the frame rate hit, guys.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix.
Oh,
initiative
cool.
Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between.
That Vetra.
Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
Hmm. Yeah, I remembered the name. Sounded familiar, but I didn't connect it to the female Krogan. So this is actually technically... Well... As far as I know, as far as, like... ones that you interact with, the third female Turian. The first is what's her name on Omega, Nyrene, and the second is part of the Citadel DLC. You try to find Garrus a date with her, and I'm not sure she even had a name. And now number three. So what's wrong?
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Uh-oh.
Damn it.
Is there a problem?
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director
oh, Addison.
Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right?
Be easy on him. He's just doing what he's told.
Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Oh god, look at her.
Really?
Yeah, really.
All you have to do is play ball.
They told me he wasn't essential. But I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
She sounds familiar.
Addison's gonna kill me.
Smooth.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
I don't know if I want to leave yet.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Everything's state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Lesser crew, of course. The best in their field.
Good to see you're looking so well, Sarah.
Thank you.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
Gil?
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey.
Wrench jockey.
We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer.
Suvi.
Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together.
Cool.
It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
So would we run around and look around on here as well as on the Nexus? That's cool. This will be an adventure.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part.
My quarters?
When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge.
The engine?
Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
Research capabilities. I have stuff to do, though. I'm kind of, like, not done with... Okay, it went right here. Okay, so we've done that. So other than that, priority is this one that we know. We did this. Missing arcs. Looked at that. Helios assignments. We need to investigate the security footage. Well, I guess it's back on the Nexus. Because there was security... It said surveillance or security footage. But it was just a bunch of emails. So I guess we gotta do that. Investigate murder evidence, which is on a planet. Which we can go to. But I kinda wanna wrap up this whole saboteur thing. Since I'm assuming we don't have to go around the galaxy to do that. So I get tasked. The model of the spheres. Travel the cluster and take planetary scans to improve Dr. Aradana's celestial model. So this is scan planets across Helios, 50 of them. Professor Herrick is working on a comparative wildlife conservation effort. Travel the cluster and take scans of any unknown wildlife. Now it's too bad. 0 out of 10. It's too bad. We did scan some wildlife, or... Actually, yeah, one specimen of wildlife. Guess that didn't count. Back on Habitat 7. Lost brother. Nigel McCoy's brother Dash died on Eos. It's one of the little ponies. To honor Dash, Nigel has asked you to place a family pendant at a spot on the planet where his brother went to think. Could always, like, not do it and then say, hey, okay, we put it there. Use your scanner on Uncharted World to test out Chief Lucan's new Geophysics Survey 6. So we got 16 of those and missing scientists. Dr. Aradana sent a team out to study the Scourge. They haven't reported in. She fears the worst and asks you to find out what happened to them. Find the missing science vessel. That's pretty important, I think. And then completed missions. Getting to know you, getting to know all about you, and all that stuff. Okay. So I'm going to look around here. And then I'm most probably heading back to the Nexus to try to finish up...
The meeting room.
You can make vid calls from the central table, or just get the crew together.
Stop watching me. So yeah, I want to wrap that up before we leave and go other places. Cool. Oh, we got this hexagonal pattern here. Didn't notice that at first. Oh, we can go down. Oh, okay. I'm making sure we can't open anything, interact with stuff. How fancy smancy. You wasted money on stuff like this. You could have used it to improve the cryogenic suspension and sensors so that they wouldn't break down.
We call this the research room. You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Thanks. You guys are talking in my head way too much here. But yeah, they could have improved sensor array, possibly, and left that table out. Let's look down here. Oh, there's Liam.
Pathfinder, check this toy.
It's a toy? Is that what it is? And I have to go like that.
Seems like we're forever racing, but there's always time to check out new toys. Useful ones.
I'm all about what's useful.
Oh, this is. Especially if you grabbed anything from Habitat 7. Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter.
A few.
The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
Okay. More choice has to help.
Options are good. We need more of those. For everybody.
Yeah, well, everybody should be so lucky. This tech is aces. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
R&D, research and development. Okay. Research to unlock new blueprints and augmentations using the research data you've acquired. Select development to craft new items and upgrades. Weapons include 4 different classes of guns. Augmentations I'm interested in. Each research category is different research data. Milky Way, Helios, and Remnant. Switch categories with Q and E. Okay, so that's not available. Milky Way, Helios. Select a blueprint or augmentation and hit space to research. Ooh, look at that! Huh. The DAN is a Ket semi-automatic weapon which unleashes a single plasma-surrounded projectile that causes devastating damage. The DAN's large and dense projectiles can knock down opponents and generate magnetic fields sufficient to sustain plasma spheres. DAN appears to translate to Peacebringer. Okay, how are we finding out about their language now, seriously? Hesh shotgun? The semi-automatic Hesh, translated to Order, is a Ket weapon that fires clusters of plasma-surrounded projectiles. Fired rounds are powerful enough to stagger most foes and demand submission from the rest. Cool. So these are energy weapons, which is cool, I think. Because I always found it kind of a bummer that you're playing this science fiction, you know, you're playing in this science fiction world and you're still shooting things with assault rifles and shotguns. These energy weapons are going to be right up my alley. Naladin Sniper Rifle. The Naladin, translated to Taker, is a scoped rifle capable of firing plasma-surrounded projectiles that explode on impact and burn anyone in the immediate vicinity. The Naladin mixes precision targeting with indiscriminate damage. What that says about Ket military culture is a subject best left to expert xenosociologists. Do we bring any of those with us? Roserad SMG. Cool. I can just go like this, you guys can see. A deadly cat submachine gun with plasma-surrounded projectiles. It almost looks like a grenade on the end, see that? The Roserad's firing rate increases with every shot. Although clearly designed for Ket, the Roserad translated to infinite fire, appears to incorporate technology from another species, perhaps an ally or Ket vassal. I want that. It's infinite. Infinite fire. Soned assault rifle. The massive Ket Soned, translated as resistance, rapidly unleashes plasma-surrounded projectiles after a brief charging period. Much of the Soned's size is devoted to insulating the user from its own power. A damaged Soned could incinerate its wielder's hands while continuing to fire. Wow. Okay, sounds dangerous. Thoken assault rifle. The Ket Thoken, translated to sudden death, fires tracking-enabled plasma-surrounded rounds. The tracking effect, enabled by magnetic field adjusters in the projectiles, is slight but useful, particularly given the Thoken's low ammunition capacity. With such a weapon, accuracy is everything. Zalkin assault rifle. The Ket Zalkin rifle is a mainstay among Ket forces. The semi-automatic weapon can be overcharged to release its standard plasma-surrounded projectiles in a three-round burst at increased power, a feature which earned the weapon its name, roughly translated as three stars. Ket Karfalon. Ooh. Nice. That thing looks like a friggin' sword. The Ket Karfalon blade can directly inject the user's hand with a variety of neurochemical stimulants. The Karfalon reinforces the body's reward mechanisms, allowing a combatant to overcome pain and fatigue after successful strikes. The weapon's ability to adapt to various species suggests the Ket occasionally give them to favored vassals. And the Ket Vakarsh, translated as punitive immolation, works on a similar principle as Ket firearms. A mechanical core, in this case a blade, maintains a magnetic field containing superheated plasma. The Vakarsh lacks the cutting power of a monomolecular weapon and ignites its victims instead. Well, it's always a good thing. Okay, so what if I... Can I just, like, pick anything? Yeah. I'm gonna worry. I don't know if this could harm me, but Wait. Kind of worried about this. This has a very, yeah. Tracking effect, yeah. This looks neat, but it says very low ammunition capacity. I kind of like this thing. Now, can I just do this? Zalkin Assault Rifle 1. So that, yeah, there's the stats. Are you sure you want to research this project? The blueprint will be added to the development branch of the research and development terminal. You can launch the development once you have gathered all the required resources. Okay, yeah, let's go. Researching weapons or armor adds their blueprints to the development screen, where they can be crafted. Researching augmentations grants you one copy of that augmentation and allows more to be found in the field. Okay. So, can I use this now? Or do we need to do more research? Unknown. Okay, so that's weapons, armor. Just gonna go through all this and then we'll see if I have access to that weapon. Cat fusion arms. Alright. Says all this for the same thing. Pathfinder implants. Although this hard suits basic materials, ceramic armor plating and kinetic padding are initiative standard, Ket Biotech permeates the overall design and feeds directly into the user's nervous system. Ket armor enhances combat prowess through chemical regulation and stimulation. This derivative armor can achieve the same result in conjunction with a SAM and Pathfinder implants. And then Helios. Well, I like the look of that. This hard suit is the ultimate project of initiative research into Helios cluster species. Remnant power sources supply Angaran hardware in a frame made possible by Ket bioenhancements and Pathfinder implants. This armor is unequivocally a combat suit intended for the defense of initiative and Angaran colonies. You are its first and only user. All feedback is welcome. Reminds me of a Quarian suit, kind of, you know, at least this part. Actually, the helmet kind of reminds me a little of it, too. Alright, I kind of want to select that. But let's look at augmentations first. Is there anything in here? Oh. Ricochet system. Ultra rare. This is a gun projectile augmentation. You may apply one such augment to a gun during the development process. Each projectile bounces off of flat surfaces. Augmentations are rare materials that can be added to some blueprints. Items incorporating augments can be more powerful or behave differently. Cool. There's a lot of options with this. Cooling or coolant unit. This is a special augmentation. You may apply one such augment to an item, blah blah blah. Increases clip size by 20% when special ammo is active. Bioconverter. When the current ammo clip is empty, drain 5% of health and refill the clip. Interesting. Plasma charge system. Non-shotgun weapons. Fires direct line explosive plasma bolts. Charge weapon to fire a devastating blast. That's neat. Or for shotguns, fires direct line explosive plasma bolts, each less damage than normal rounds. Charge weapon for more. Okay, this stupid thing's in the way. Concentration module. Plus 10% weapon accuracy when shields are 20% or lower. Okay, for that little boost when you're about to die. Seeking plasma system. Sorry about that, guys. Changes weapon projectile to seeking plasma bolts. And battlefield assist module. For weapon, when health and shields are full, plus 20% damage, or chest when health is 20% or lower, plus 25% resistance to all damage. And that's it. Okay, I do want to look at this armor. The chest. We need 230. Yeah. We need more. Alright. I'm gonna save my points for this. If you have enough, like say I have 350, can I just jump right to this? That'd be cool. See, because that's something I would do. I would, like, if you can in this game, I would grind for cash and just get the highest one. Because I don't know if you can do that. You might have to go in succession. Although they put it all there, so maybe you can just skip. Since they've laid it out, everything out for you. Of course, somehow we know what Ket words translate to, even though they haven't said a word around us, that we can understand anyway. Oh, and then we got development. Okay. Ready to develop. So, Avenger Assault Rifle, we know this stuff. A common and versatile assault rifle. The M8 Avenger's modular design and inexpensive components make it a favorite of military groups and mercenaries in the Milky Way. Many Avengers were acquired for Andromeda Initiative security forces. The sturdy rifle has a reputation for being reliable and easy to use. Do I use points for this? Or is this a different system? Carnifex pistol? I remember these. A heavy semi-automatic pistol, the powerful Carnifex was the preferred choice of Milky Way mercenaries. Milky Way Milkenaries. An expensive weapon, its marketing materials featured a charging Krogan alongside the tagline, "Don't you wish Carnifex was at your side?" Disciple Shotgun 1. A relatively lightweight shotgun originally built in the Milky Way for Asari Justicars and Commandos. The semi-automatic Disciple uses shells packed with microscale submunitions to inflict serious damage. The Initiative have only a small number of Disciples due to the Asari's unwillingness to freely share their design. Incisor Sniper Rifle. Capable of three-shot bursts, the Incisor was part of a new... This turns, yeah. Come on. Milky Way Sniper was part of a new wave of Milky Way Sniper Rifles designed to overload a foe's defenses. It was advertised as having negligible recoil, though the second and third rounds frequently climb in combat conditions, distributing damage along a vertical line. Matok. Oh, it's my favorite. It was my favorite in Mass Effect 3. The M96 Matok's increased power is favored by marksmen looking to bring down hardened targets. Oh yeah, those Emer. Not the Emer. The Atlas mechs. Oh, those big-ass mechs. Its lack of automatic setting was originally advertised as a feature rather than a shortcoming, as it curbs a user's tendency to spray inaccurate fire under stress. And the Phalanx pistol. In the Milky Way, the M5 Phalanx was the product of the Alliance's offensive handgun project. It is an accurate, close-quarters weapon with minimal recoil and solid stopping power. The versions purchased by the Andromeda Initiative were intended for civilian use, but are modified for more robust applications. Okay. So, for this, I don't... Are you sure you want to develop? We can change the name of it for some reason? Well, I wouldn't do that, because I want you guys to know what the hell it is. So I think that maybe doesn't use points. Give me the Matok. View required materials. So we have some stuff. Wait, is this... I'm guessing this is how much we have and how much you need. We have exactly enough iron. Broadly useful for multiple engineering purposes. A common metallic element found in many planetary cores. 40 out of... I don't remember getting this stuff. Fluorite? A mineral used for creating precision scientific lenses among other applications. And element zero, of course we know what that is. Oh, nice and shiny like that. So, I don't think I can craft this, but let me try. I have it somehow. Okay. That's my journal. Which one do I have for inventory? This one. I just wanna, you know, I could have gone through the menu. I just want to get myself really familiar with these keys here. There's the Matok. Hey, baby. We'll see if I like it as well in this game as in Mass Effect 3. So I'm guessing we have to go, into the weapon wheel or whatever to change that. But I can't do that this time. So I'm guessing for the cat weapon, I have to do more research. Wait, we got research here. Armor blueprints. I didn't add to that. I added to this. There's the Zalkin. Okay. I guess I have a blueprint of it. I have to go somewhere else to make it or have it made for me. Biotic amplifier. Well, that's new. A specialized bioamp originally manufactured by the Milky Way's Aldrin Labs. Allows a user to essentially wrap a Mass Effect field around their fist and strike an opponent with enormous, often staggering, force. Katana shotgun. Okay, this stuff is just automatically added. The M23 Katana was a popular shotgun among Milky Way soldiers, criminals, and civilians. It was manufactured by Ariake Technologies, an Earth-based company eager to do business with the Andromeda Initiative. Yes, buy our stuff and then leave the galaxy, thank you. M3 Predator Pistol. A reliable semi-automatic pistol. Originally manufactured by Atlantis Risk Control, the rapid-fire Predator is a deadly and inexpensive weapon. Although Milky Way militaries generally avoided using the Predator, the Andromeda Initiative obtained and adjusted several hundred of them. Alright. So it wanted me to look at those. Resources, minerals. So we have lithium somehow. How are we getting a hold of this stuff? I guess it was just here at this station. A useful light metal used in multiple engineering applications, including vehicle batteries, radiation shields, and high quality steel production. So we can also purchase all this crap from merchants if we really need it. We do have... Okay. So we had 200 of that stuff. What does it want me to look at? Oh, Vetra's here. Oh. Drifter Mercenary level 3. So she was level 0 for a second. So she has power armor. A life lived outside the establishment turned Vetra into a street-smart survivor. Unorthodox skills picked up from her time as a smuggler make her a dangerous opponent. But it's her piecemeal kit collected over years of trading with the criminal underworld that lets her dish out real damage while protecting herself and her allies. Well, that does tell us about her past a little bit. Cool. Alright. That's cool. I can give her stuff. Okay. So she has concussive shot. I like that. Turian smuggler. The combination of Vetra's military training and her experiences as a smuggler improves her offensive capabilities. So plus 15 weapon damage. An offensive expert. Vetra's gear and training improves her abilities to survive hostile encounters. I do want to take that stuff, but first, I do like concussive shot. And power armor. Vetra's custom armor hardens and activates reinforced shields, providing her with unrivaled protection. This has 2 points. Can I start off Turian Smuggler? Yeah. Plus 15% weapon damage, that's worth it. Cool. Leveled up, baby. Confirmed. Now why is it still telling me to look here? Oh, because they can level up now? Again? Cora and Liam? I didn't notice that little icon there. She has 1 point. So it's going to say that while we have 1 point, is what it is. I'm just going to get him started with some of these basic, you know, their class skills, as it were. Codex, yeah, I'm going to read that at some point. Completed missions. We have new completed mission. Oh, yeah. You have reactivated a research center on Eos. Test its capabilities by gathering the resources to craft a weapon. Okay. So that's what... Wait. We're on Eos now? What? Why does it say we're on Eos? We haven't left yet. We're still on the station. Gil, Liam, Biolab, Tech Lab, Airlock, Escape Pods. We were using Escape Pods as the model of the sphere. Scan planets across Helios. Cool. Travel the cluster and take planetary scans to improve Dr. Aridana's celestial model. That's cool. So, stairs to Deck 3. Gil. So over here we have Cora and Vetra up here, Lexi and Sam, the galley, med bay, including respec station, crew quarters, Pathfinder's quarters. We'll have an email terminal, wardrobe, Sam, and a music system. Nice. Back to Shepherd's cabin, cargo bay, storage, armory. Oh my god, is Ryder gonna dance? And deck 1, meeting room with the VidCon. You always have the meeting room, always all by itself, and you have to travel all the way through the ship sometimes to get to it. Show the legend, toggle waypoint. Okay, another long episode. Wow, guys. Because I was reading on and on about this stuff. Thanks so much for watching, and I'm in shadow. Here, look at Liam then. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. And enduring, grow strong. Why are you looking at me, girl? Why are you looking at me now? Girl, why are you looking at me? Girl, still looking at me. Ah, forget about you.